I am absolutely happy to open this session dedicated to 90th birthday of Viktor Abramovich Dolgalla. I know him for some 65 years. Namely, we met first in March of 46, when I started to attend his special group for high school children interested in mathematics in Leningrad. And it was just the influence of these studies that mathematics became my profession. So I adapted to Professor Dolgalla for this, for my profession. And Viktor spent the years of the war against the Nazi Germany as a soldier in the Soviet army. After the victory, he returned to his studies and he graduated from the Faculty of Mathematics and Mechanics of the Leningrad University in 1948. After this, and until his Aliyah in 1999, all his life is connected with the Leningrad branch of the Steklov Mathematical Institute and with his alma mater. And this was in spite of the very sad fact that there were mighty forces in the post-war Soviet Union trying to prevent such connections. And how to evaluate the renown of a scientist? There are some formal ways, say by the number of publication or by that of references. The both quantities are large enough for Viktor Dolgalla, but there exists a less formal way. Namely, what is the class of problems, the range of problems worth discussing with this person, and what could be the result of such a discussion? And in this respect, Viktor Dolgalla is certainly one of absolute champions. You could approach him with a question from any branch of mathematics, not necessarily from geometry, and he immediately started to think about your problem, and as a rule, in a short time, he would give you a non-trivial and extremely useful advice. I myself had a privilege to use his help, and I was not alone. Say, the famous number theorist and probabilist Yuri Linnik repeatedly asked him for an advice, and here is a funny story related to one of such cases. It was about a year ago. I met Viktor, who was in rather bad moods. Something happened, I asked him. Oh, many years ago, in late 60s, Linnik asked me a question. I answered it, and later the result was published. But it seems to me now that my proof had a flaw. So after 50 years, he started rethinking the problem, but in a couple of days we met again and he said with relief, no, everything was correct. And all this was in addition to the well-known fact that for many years he served the right hand for such giants as Leonid Kantorovich and Alexandrov. I believe I expressed a general feeling towards Viktor Dolgalla, saying that we are happy to see you here in a good health and high moods, and we wish you many happy returns of this day. And now we start a meeting. We have today we have two lectures, one a full lecture. It will be given by Professor Burada, and another will be some shorter communication given by Professor Romanovsky. Yuri Dmitrich, please.